Welcome back to HHO Gas Technology. Today we're going to be breaking loose a wheel bearing in a drum. Matt, explain what's been going on.
Well, I've got my wheel bearing. It's stuck. I've got the inside out, but the race is stuck in the drum. So I pounded it, and I cannot get it free.
How long were you working on it?
Oh, at least an hour and a half.
And we're going to be busting it loose with 100% HHO gas. And this machine is making 93 liters per minute. Set the camera up. This is our pounding area on the old concrete. We're not going to do it on the new. The new is not as strong as the old. As you can see, the rocks in there, it can take a beating. Today's technology concrete is garbage. It's sand. Well, sand don't hold anything.
See the water forming on the bottom of there?
Wow.
Thank you.
see how it turns red on the surface. You can't do that with a regular flame.
Wow.
That's instant red. But we're trying to get heat through. We don't want it red hot. We want to heat. Okay, take it over there.
Okay.
Let me grab some pliers. You can grab that socket, hold it straight.
I might need some.
Hold on, let me go get the channel lock.
Okay.
Well, you beat the crap out of it without banging your finger.
Right, that's the only thing I'm worried about. Smack my finger.
There you go, grab it, pound the crap out of it. Bring it back over or we'll put some more heat to it.
Okay.
It'll probably cool down some.
Can't tell if it budged it at all.
We'll get it warmer.
As you can see, I'm not putting any heat on the thin part on the bottom, as you can see.
Boy.
Pinpoint heat. Ready? Ready to grab it? Ready.
You spent an hour and a half.
Sweet.
Yep.
Like I said, there's nothing HHO Gas cannot fix.
Wow. That is amazing.
It's first time seeing it. Man, it goes to my church.
Wow.
And you couldn't break that loose.
No, it was wedged in there.
Oh yeah, we've seen it before the last time you hit it.
The bearing just fell apart. I hit it so hard. That's what I was using was the old bearing, and it just fell to pieces.
Yeah.
Look at that. There's all the tumblers from the bearing.
Excellent machine for any machine shop or auto shop.
Wow.
Pinpoint heating. We didn't even apply heat to the thin part down here. Only to the thick. It's pinpoint heating.
It didn't heat the rest of the drum at all.
Here, I'll grab my laser heat.
Can't find it. After all the stuff I've done,
things got misplaced.
Look at that, you can see where all the old bearing was.
Yeah.
It even left little lines from where all the tumblers, because this is the inner guts.
Right.
Wow.
And we've been recording only for 12 minutes and 42 seconds. That would take a long time to heat up with oxygen and acetylene. A long time.
I tried it in my oven. And it just didn't, it wasn't enough heat. And it was heating everything.
Yep.
And it wasn't effective.
Wow. Let me go see if I can take one more look at my garage so I can find it.
Got it. Put it back down.
Okay.
Check the,
the inner is 488 and the thin part is 340 degrees. The drum part out here, we get the words rusty, we can pick up the temperature. 253 for the outside. So inner 400 degrees. The thin wall where the lug nuts go through. The studs, I mean, we're at 380, 373. It's starting to transfer across, but if I would have had the laser gauge out when we're done, it would have been a lot cooler. Right now, it's transferring across like a heat sink.
Wow.
But when we're doing it, it's actually cooler on the outside. Right here, it would be actually cooler than what you're doing in here.
Wow.
But since I took time to find it, after the wedding thing got misplaced, it started to transfer across as a heat sink.
Holy
and on the outside is 289. If that was oxygen settling, that radiant heat would have transferred all inside that whole drum, all the way around. It would have just been a massive flame of heat.
Oh yeah, and it would have been everywhere.
And we kept it right on the inner part where
nice
the race was.
Focused. And it didn't spread out everywhere.
It didn't spread out. HHO gas doesn't spread out, but if you add a fossil fuel in the bubbler, then you can control the spread of the flame, but it actually cools the flame when you add a fossil fuel. So we're keeping it at its hottest point.
Intense, just intense, pure heat.
If I would have kept it there, we would have melted it. That's why I kept moving it. As you've seen, it was turning red instantly on contact.
Oh, yeah.
If I would have held it there, then I would have ruined the whole drum itself.
Right, it would have ended up warping it
and melted. As
wow.
You can see, there's a little heat right there on the... Right there, it melted the grease.
Fantastic. That is fantastic.
Another job done by HHO. Peter Crunk out for now.
All blue. bring it back. Creating a draft right now. Get it in there. And you can see the change.